1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 17 commands believers to pray without ceasing. And in Luke chapter 18 verse 1, the Lord Jesus commanded that men ought always to pray and not faint. And finally, Ephesians chapter 6 verse 18 says, "And pray in the Spirit on all occasions, with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the Lord's people." These are just a few Bible verses that serve as a reminder to all believers about just how important prayer is to our lives. You see, prayer is vital for our spiritual growth and maturity. That's why we are commanded to pray without ceasing. Prayer is what draws us closer to God. And according to Jeremiah 33 verse 3, prayer is our mode of communication with the Lord, because the Bible says, "Call to me and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things which you do not know." It's only through prayer that we hear from God and keep our minds on Him. Prayer is the channel that we can release our fears, release our concerns and all our anxieties. Prayer is how we make our requests known to God, and also a way in which we lift up our praise and thanks to the Lord. According to Proverbs 15 verse 8, prayer brings delight and pleasure to God. Because the Bible reads, "The Lord detests the sacrifice of the wicked, but the prayer of the upright pleases Him." Furthermore, we are required to pray, because prayer deepens our fellowship with the Lord. And according to Psalm 42 verse 1 and 2, the Bible says, "As the deer pants for the streams of water, so my soul pants for you, my God. My soul thirsts for God, for the living God. Where can I go and meet with God?" You and I need to understand that as we grow in our prayer lives, then our relationship with God will also grow and benefit from this. I will get to know Him better and know the power of His resurrection. And so with this understanding, let us pray. Dear Lord Jesus, I thank You for my life and for Your love for me. I thank You for Your hand of protection that's upon my life. And I praise You because that protection extends to cover my family. I pray today that You may continue to open the eyes of my understanding, Lord, so that I may know and pray without ceasing. Your word, O God, says, "It's Your will that we pray." So help me, Father, to do Your will. Help me to do that which delights You. I pray, Lord, that I may not be a prayerless Christian. I pray that I may not be the type of believer who only prays when it benefits me. I open myself up to divine deliverance. May Your Holy Spirit lead me, guide me, and make intercession for me with groanings that cannot be uttered, according to Your word in Romans chapter 8 verse 26. As I pray, Lord, may I be drawn closer and closer to You, and may my fellowship with You continue to deepen. May I continue to grow in the knowledge of who You are, and may I experience Your power working in my life. Teach me to converse with You in prayer and remind me to always listen. Overflow my heart, Father, with gratitude for all that you have done for me, gratitude for all that you are doing in my life, and for that which you are still yet to do for me in the name of Jesus. I pray that my life will become one that is continuously led by prayer, regardless of where I am or who I'm with. I pray that I bless you, Lord, at all times, and that your praises will continually be in my mouth. And as I keep my mind focused on you, keep me, Lord, in your perfect peace. Help me, Father God, to make prayer my lifestyle, so that it becomes a part of me. I pray, Lord, for a humble spirit, a prayerful spirit, so that my heart will always be inclined to pray. Perform a good work within me and change my attitude so that it becomes one that is given to prayer. I ask that the Holy Spirit will help me to be disciplined with my time each day, so that I will make prayer a priority in my life, just as Jesus did when he walked the earth. Isaiah 55 verse 6 says, "Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call on him while he is near. Help me, Lord, to seek you always. Give me the strength to seek your face continually." I pray, Father, in the name of Jesus, that I may seek you while you still may be found, as your word tells me. I pray that I may call upon your name whilst you are still near. Cultivate in me a spirit that is habitually devotional, keeping my heart tuned in to your frequency. I pray, Father, that I may continue to rejoice in hope and to be patient in tribulation, standing in faith for you to deliver me. Thank you, Lord, for your word, which says men ought to pray and not to lose heart. I pray that you will give me strength to always pray and not to faint in my prayers. Help me, Lord, to be obedient to your word, so that I may not be anxious for nothing, but in every situation by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, I may present my request to you, Lord. Your word says, "By worrying, we will not add anything to our lives." So help me, God, to do something more meaningful with my time than worry. I pray that your word may be in my heart, so that it will direct my steps each and every day. Let no evil have dominion over me, Lord. And just as your word says in Jeremiah, "Heal me, O Lord, and I will be healed. Save me, and I will be saved, for you are the one I praise." Revive my prayer life, O Lord, that I may be forever in your presence. Help me always to guard my life and my heart with prayer. I bless your name, Father, and give all the praise and adoration to you, mighty Lord. Strengthen me in my prayer life, because victory comes only through you, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I thank you for hearing this prayer. Amen.